White-tailed deer are nibbling on your garden or shrubs. It could be worse. In tonight's Wild Moment, Jack Hubley goes in search of another member of the deer family that's a whole lot bigger than the average Susquehanna Valley whitetail.
Of all North America's deer, elk are second in size only to moose. A mature bull elk can measure 4.5 feet at the shoulders and weigh 900 pounds. Elk were once found throughout the Northeast, but they're best known as a resident of the Rocky Mountains. In fact, elk from the Rockies were used to restore Pennsylvania's elk herd early in the 20th century. But another subspecies of elk, this one named after a former president, can be found in the Pacific Northwest. Roosevelt elk are found west of the Cascade Mountains, from British Columbia to Oregon. They're a bit larger than the Rocky Mountain variety, but they can still be mighty hard to find in country this big. Ranger Jim Shayburl and I searched the high meadows of Washington's Mount Rainier National Park, but we couldn't find a single elk. Oh, we finally did catch up with the elk. They were in the forest all right, a forested housing development.
So here we are in the Washington State suburban wilderness stalking the wily elk. The biggest hazard stalking elk in this country is basically private property issues.
Well, that's not the only hazard. Down boy. But the results were worth it. We found sleek cows with spotted calves. And we found bulls, yearlings with spiked antlers, and older branch-antlered bulls. What is it that prompts these big deer to snuggle up to civilization? It could be that lush, tender turf grass, or those scrumptious garden vegetables.
I just talked to a neighbor over there who said this cow was over eating his tomatoes, so he just assumed we'd chase her out of the neighborhood.
Whatever the reason, these big deer have adapted well to human encroachment. So much for our wilderness elk story. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.